Hi students, this is Kameshwari from Nalla Narasimha Reddy Education Society group of institutions. Today we are going to discuss about consolidation unit 4. In previous class we are already discussed what is consolidation, what is difference between compaction and consolidation. Expulsion of air voice from the soil is called as a compaction, and also expulsion of water from the soil is called as consolidation. So this is already discussed. So compaction is a very short period of time, and compaction is, it takes more time and very slow process. So expulsion of water from the soil is called as a consolidation. Here primary consolidation and secondary consolidation, normally consolidation. Now the today topic is some of the definitions of compression index. What is compression index? So it is the very important formulas for solving the problems. Compression index is equal to slope of the linear portion of the void ratio versus log plot. So CC, what is CC? That CC is equal to compression index. CC is equal to compression index. That is equal to delta E by log of sigma dash by sigma naught dash. That is equal to sigma bar equal to effective stress. Effective stress definition, it is the difference between the total stress and neutral stress. So effective stress, so sigma bar and sigma naught, that is equal to variation, initial effective stress and also final effective stress. The change between the initial and final effective stress is indicated by sigma naught, sigma naught bar and sigma bar. And also E is equal to, that means void ratio, original void ratio, here indicated by delta E. That means change in void ratio. Void ratio will be changes during the procedure, that volumes, voids between the soil particles will be expelled by compaction and consolidation. So the numerical value of CC can be easily determined from the difference in void ratios corresponding to one log cycle, the difference in the void ratios. So it is determination of the settlement in the field. Consolidation will be done over field. The value of CC, compression index, normally the value will be varied 0.3 for high plastic clays and also 0.75 for low plastic clays. So the value will be changes from 0.3 to 0.75. So the values will be changes from 0.3 to 0.75. That will be varies high plastic clays to low plastic clays. And the quotient of compressibility may be calculated from the compression index, and also calculated from the compression index. That is equal to A suffix V is equal to A suffix V is equal to, sorry, A suffix V is equal to compression index 0.435 into CC by delta sigma naught. That means original initial effective stress, compression index by CC by delta sigma bar naught. That is equal to change in average pressure for the increment. Coefficient of compressibility may be calculated from the compression index. That is equal to A suffix V is equal to 0.435 CC by sigma A bar. Sorry, this is sigma A bar. That means A means average pressure of the increment. and expansion index or swelling index. The expansion index as swelling index is the slope of the graph is versus between void ratio and change in stress during the uploading. That is equal to CC, compression index is equal to CE, expansion index is equal to delta E. That means change in void ratio by sigma bar, effective stress, change in effective stress. Delta sigma bar is equal to change in effective stress by sigma bar, effective stress, change in effective stress, and change in void ratio. It is the difference between the void ratio and stresses. So as it is evident, the expansion or swelling index is much smaller than the compression index. Next, recompression index. This is also the graph is in between change in pressure and also effective stresses. The load during recompression is less than the load to which the soil has been subjected previously. Recompression means load during recompression is less than the load to which soil has been subjected previously. So the range is in between 1 by 10 to 1 by 5 of the compression index. So recompression index is approximately smaller than the compression index. And also coefficient of volume change. Coefficient of volume change. Another equation, coefficient of volume change. This volume change, this is one of the important formula. It is asked in our short answers questions also. Volumetric strain per unit increase in effective stress. Change in void volume change. M suffix V. So it is the difference strain per increasing the effective stress. It is the difference between the change in volume to the change in effective stresses. V naught indicated by initial volume. Delta V indicated by change in volume. And effective stress means sigma bar. So here we can write delta sigma bar. That means initial and final change in the effective stresses. So also we can written as a MV is equal to AB into 1 plus E naught. And also compression, coefficient of compressibility. A suffix V is equal to change in void ratio to the change in effective stress. It is the decrease in void ratio per unit increase in effective stresses. It is the difference between the change in the void ratio to the change in the effective stresses. And square root of the time fitting method. Here the time is the consolidation. How much time required for consolidate the soil? So it take more time. 2 days. Some cases longer time and then 2 days is minimum 2 days is time. So how much soil will be consolidated? So time factor. Time required for to achieve 90% consolidation. And also time required for, how much time required for consolidate the soil. The graph is in between the time factor plotted between the U and TV. That means time factor. CV is equal to, generally CV. As per this method, the graph is plotted between the U and TV. This is the found straight. The graph is 0 to, so stress will be increased. CV is equal to T90 into D square by small T90, where capital T90, time factor for 90% of consolidation. Here the value will be constant 0.848. And D is equal to length of the drainage path. And also small T90 is equal to time required to achieve 90% of the consolidation. So CV is equal to 0.848 D square by T90. And also logarithmic method. here how much time required for consolidation? The time required to achieve 50%, time required to achieve 90% consolidation. So time will be varied from starting to ending. So before you are going to conduct a test and ending the test, so how much time required? So time required to achieve 90% consolidation. So here also T50 is equal to 0.197. The graph is drawn between the VN volume and log time factor TV. So here also the time will be varied drainage path and length of the drainage path. In this method, the graph is between these two. This approach was suggested by A. Cresagrande. So what is Cresagrande? In unit 1, we all discussed from basic geotechnical engineering, liquid limit determined by using the Cresagrande apparatus. So these are the definitions used for solving the problems in consolidation. Definitions asked for short answers questions, and also in long answer questions also it can be asked as a logarithmic time fitting method and also square root of the fitting method. So these are the definitions and formulas for used in our consolidation. So very, very important these definitions. Please remind guys. So next class we are discussing next topic. Thank you. Thank you all.